first of all, the project spoke to me. I went to work with Aegis. No, but also what was important about it, I think, you know, the political discussion, you got stuff about immigration, but also I think there's not that much content on TV that has a family that happens to be black or African. This is the first in many years, or the first ever. But also, you know, what I loved about it, that it wasn't just about them being African, it was about them being a family in the heart of East London. And I think what Aegis has created in Sky and Green Door is that you can create great content that it crosses over universally, all sorts of people from different demographics, races and ages, they watched it, they enjoyed it. And but also for me, that means that let's make more of that content, you know, let's trust, let's stop sort of going, well, we've not seen anything like that before, we don't know how it's going to go down. You know, if the content's good and you back it in its right way, that's like Sky backed in the long run, then we can have, I feel like, 10, 14 other types of in the long run. I don't mean comedies, I just mean, I mean inclusive, diverse content. That's what I mean, basically, you know? If you look at it, it's got great female characters, you know, it's got a great diverse cast, and also we had a great female director, the writer team was diverse, two women, two men, and, you know, and then you got, you know, the great producers as well. You got someone like Idris Elba, Gina Carter, and Charlie Hansen. I think, you know, when you look at the front and the back end of the show and how it's made up, for me, that's how sort of TV and film should be done. For Aegis, you know, him being back here in the UK now, I think he's conscious of the position that he's in. He doesn't have to do the work he's doing, but he's choosing to tell the stories he wants to tell, but also that fit in terms of what the current conversation is, and fits in with his speech that he did at the House of Commons, you know. And so, but also this is a personal story for him, so it was quite hard. His father passed quite a few years back, and so this is him sort of putting his personal story out there in the public. It's loosely based on his personal story, but it is. And so that's why I think it's important for him, but also he's very generous, Idris. He is trying to help bring talent through. Just like, you know, just like myself, I've got a company called Trifles Creative Network, and we do initiatives like Monologue Slam UK is a free actor showcase to be seen by diverse actors. We do film festivals. You know, it's one of the cheapest in the world, you know, to submit your films and to be seen by people at BAFTA. And I think Idris is all about, let me use my position to open the doors of the industry, because it's still a bit closed off, there's still a bit of nepotism, there's still a bit, you know, middle class and white male, and it's nice that Idris and Green Door and Sky are creating content that is, challenging that situation.